Sports Extra, 20 minutes of local team highlights.
Brought to you exclusively by Hiller's Flooring America.
For us, it's still the high school football season until the Prep Bowl is officially over, so that's why we have ourselves some football in the background tonight. Kind of wish I was back a couple months ago. But as we know, winter sports kicked into high gear tonight.
I'm Mark Powell, alongside sports director Pat Lund. Girls basketball started last night. There were more games tonight, including a tournament up in Red Wing. The Goodhue Wildcats finished as the Class A runner-ups a year ago. This year, moving up to Double A, taking on River Falls tonight in Red Wing. First half, the Wildcats started out hot. Alyssa Lodermeyer drives and gets the bucket. Wildcats up four. Later, more Goodhue. This time, more Lodermeyer turning defense into offense, laying it in for two of her 19 points. Still in the half, River Falls would respond. Kylie Strope drives and lays it in, but Goodhue was up at the break. Second half, more Goodhue. This time, Lodermeyer finds Annika Schaefer. That is a three. Then later, check this one out. Ariana Tomford sinks the baseline jumper. Goodhue rolls in this one. They win 63-47. In the late game, the eighth-ranked Wingers of Red Wing looking for revenge this year after Austin upset them last year in the section playoffs hosting PEM. First half, this one was all Wingers. Ellie Thorson finds Kylie Nelson beyond the arc. That's buckets. Wingers up three early. Later, more Red Wing. This time it's on the break. Sydney Ron dumps it off to Abby Deming for the lay-in, but the Bulldogs would get a bucket on the other end on the set play. It's Macy Holtz there getting the deuce, but it would not be enough. Still in the half, the Wingers work it to Hallie Roshan. Great ball movement as they had it going against PEM. Red Wing rolls to a 67-35 win on opening night.
Girls hockey tonight, lone hockey game in Rochester. The Mayo Spartans hosting Irondale at Graham Arena 1. Irondale threw a lot of pucks at the net in that first period. Madeline Kunza forces the turnover. She'll go in for the tally and the 1-0 lead. Late in the second period, or first period, I should say, Irondale strikes again. Joe Malum with a beautiful shot, high glove side. Irondale with the 2-0 lead and all the momentum, but Mayo scored just before the end of the first on the power play. Watch in front of the net. Natalie Campbell, just a seventh grader, is on the doorstep cashing in to make it 2-1. Irondale would go on to the 9-3 victory. To City Arena and Albert Lee, great atmosphere for tonight's Albert Lee Marshall boys hockey game. Couple of great goals in the first period. Hustle pays off for Albert Lee's Jared Turabiartis. Plays the puck off his stick, then sends a waffler, look at that, to the back of the net. How about that? 1-0 Tigers. But check this out, Mark. One of the best goals I've seen in high school hockey in a long time. Marshall's Wyatt Boerboom plays the puck between the defenseman's legs. There he goes, gets it, finishes top shelf. How pretty was that? Jeez. It was 1-1 after the first period. A good place tonight to be at Albert Lee and City Arena. 25 seconds left in overtime, and Marshall scores the win. 4-3. Albert Lee will have something to say in Class A in this section this year. Century on the road picks up a nice win. They're up north 5-1 over Bemidji. More high school boys hockey. Waseca 6-2 at home over the Austin Packers. Winona on the road at Waconia winning 4-2. Red Wing up at Eveleth at the Hippodrome 6-0. Eveleth and Mankato East also on the road losing to Mound West Tonka 5-2. Let's head to Austin's Riverside Arena NHL hockey with the Bruins hosting the Minnesota Magicians. Austin up 3-0, headed into the third period, make that 4-0 earlier in that third. Bruins force the turnover. Ben Almquist takes advantage, finding the back of the net. Game well in hand for the Bruins. Hey, goalie Brett Miller was great between the pipes for Austin tonight. He pitched the shutout, collecting 26 saves. Nice stop there to keep the Magicians off the board in that third period. Then it was a good night in Austin at Riverside, getting the shutout. 4-0 is the final score. Coming up a little bit later, we'll show you how the Winona State volleyball team did in Sioux Falls at the NSIC volleyball tournament.
And the Austin Packers opened the season with a victory at Century last night. Tonight, they were on the road taking on KM Comets. Sports Extra will be right back after this timeout.